welcome to Social Studies, everyone. Scotty, Christopher, Pat. I hope you're excited. We're going to learn about Christopher Columbus today. But not maybe your trip. Yes?
My birthday is near Columbus Day.
Yes, it is. It's usually that same week. Sometimes your birthday falls on Columbus Day. Yes, you're right. So we're going to talk about the controversy of Christopher Columbus. Did he really discover America? And how he treated the people that already lived here. And we call the people who already lived here in the Americas indigenous people. So if you see, there's a list of vocabulary words up on the board here, and I'll have it up on the smart board in a little while. You can pull them up on your tablets as well. If you go to vocabulary.com, you have an invite and you can pull up your list, but I also have a hard copy for everyone as well. So lots of places you can find the word. So Scotty has his vocabulary list pulled up already. And if you click the word, it'll also help you hear the word and say the word for you. But let's have an introduction. So we're going to talk about Christopher Columbus, right, Scotty? And the controversy behind Christopher Columbus and his voyages and explorations to the Americas. So let's get started. All right. So now, if you have questions throughout, just look at me or raise your hand or use your switch, or you could hit the table if you need me, okay? So we're going to explore the Bahamas, the place of Columbus's first landing in the Americas, to learn more about his actions and impact on indigenous people and slave trade. So these list of words, as you hear them or see them, just make a mental note, or you could put a mark next to them as you hear the word as we're saying them, okay? There's a lot of words, and we'll go over the list after our introduction to the lesson. So though the island you will explore is not the exact island in the Bahamas where Columbus first landed, the views are similar. Imagine what it might have been like for the people who are already living on the island when Columbus first came. So imagine you're living in your home and someone comes here and says, oh, I've discovered a new place to live. How would you feel? This is your home. You've been here for years. So think about how those people felt. So let's explore. Time to explore, Scotty. So there's the Bahamas. People are living there. Columbus and the people that worked for him decided they wanted to participate, partake, and live here and claim it to be their own. But people were already living there. So that looks like a little bit of paradise. Who likes to go to the beach? Yeah, I know Scotty does too. So these are the Bahamas. We're exploring, but people live there. And Columbus is going to claim it for himself. See the trees?
Why?
All right. And then, so we went full circle. So there's trees, there's sand, there's water.
Hello, maybe.
As we're... These might be things you haven't heard in previous lessons, years past, about Columbus. So I want you to take some mental notes of what we're going to talk about. And I want you to think about these questions. We're not going to answer them now. We'll answer them in a few lessons down the road in a week or so. So what was Columbus's impact on the native people in the Americas? Do you think Columbus made a positive or negative impact on the development of the modern world? So I want you to think of these questions for future lessons. Always have those in the back of your mind. All right. So now we're going to hear about Christopher Columbus. Okay, Scotty. Hi, Scotty. All right, so we have a little video and then we'll go right into the story. So, as this is loading, remember those questions we're going to be thinking about for future lessons. Okay, Scotty.
Without a doubt, Columbus landed in the Bahamas in 1492 and made three more trips to the New World, including a visit to Cuba. His voyages paved the way for European exploration.
Okay, that's fine.
Did Columbus really discover America? The answer is most likely no. Before Columbus arrived, ancestors of modern Native Americans made their way from Asia to North America over a land bridge formed during the last ice age more than 12,000 years ago. In fact, Columbus probably was the first European to land in the Americas.
A lot of words. Some you've seen and heard before. Some are probably new for you. So the ones with the X's are the ones I want you to pay close attention to. We're going to do an activity, a fun activity with the words with the X's. But look for all these words and listen for all these words as the story is read. So you can pull up on your tablets. I sent you an invite for the Fluency Tutor. And you can hear the story read along. So you can look at the words as the story is being read to us. So do we want Ava, Samantha, or Tom to read to us? Christopher, who would you like to read to us?
Tom.
As the classroom rhyme goes, Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492 and discovered America. But there is more to the story.
You can follow on your tablets too.
We celebrate with a federal holiday on the second Monday of every October. As historians have continued to learn and write more about the real life of Christopher Columbus, controversy has arisen over the validity of honoring the explorer as a hero. Like many European explorers, Columbus encountered many indigenous people throughout his voyages. Singularly focused on his mission to find riches and conquer new lands, Columbus and his team treated the indigenous groups they came across as obstacles to their greater mission. There are three main sources of controversy involving Columbus's interactions with the indigenous people he labeled Indians. The use of violence and slavery,
the forced conversion of native peoples to Christianity, and the introduction of a host of new diseases that would have dramatic long-term effects on native people in the Americas. Historians have uncovered extensive evidence of the damage wreaked by Columbus and his teams, leading to an outcry over emphasis placed upon studying and celebrating him in schools and public celebrations. In an era in which the international slave trade was starting to grow, Columbus and his men enslaved many native inhabitants of the West Indies and subjected them to extreme violence and brutality. On this famous first voyage in 1492, Columbus landed on an unknown Caribbean island after an arduous 3-month journey. On his first day in the New World, he ordered 6 of the natives to be seized, writing in his journal that he believed they would be good servants. Throughout his years in the New World, Columbus enacted policies of forced labor in which natives were put to work for the sake of profits. Later, Columbus sent thousands of peaceful Taino Indians from the island of Hispaniola to Spain to be sold. Many died en route. Those left behind were forced to search for golden mines and on plantations. Within 60 years after Columbus landed, only a few hundred of what may have been 250,000 Taino were left on their island. As by order and viceroy of the Indies, Columbus imposed iron discipline on what is now the Caribbean country of Dominican Republic, according to documents discovered by Spanish historians in 2005. In response to native unrest and revolt, Columbus ordered a brutal crackdown in which many natives were killed. In an attempt to deter further rebellion, Columbus ordered their dismembered bodies to be paraded through the streets.
I know. Can you believe that?
In addition to the controversy over enslavement and violent rule, the age of exploration Columbus led had the additional consequence of bringing new diseases to the New World, which would, over time, devastate the native populations of many New World islands and communities. In the broader sense, historians have used the phrase Columbian exchange to describe the exchange of plants, animals, and goods between the East and West that its voyages sparked. Though the effects were widespread and cannot all be dismissed as negative, critics of Columbus have asserted that the worst aspects of this exchange added up to biological warfare. Eventually, his methods and actions caught up with Columbus. A number of settlers lobbied against him at the Spanish court, accusing Columbus of mismanagement. In 1500, the king and queen sent a royal administrator, who detained Columbus and his brothers and had them shipped home. Although Columbus regained his freedom and made a fourth and final voyage to the New World, he had lost his bearership and much of his prestige. This historical record has cast Columbus into the shadow of enormous consequence. Protests at Columbus Day, parades, efforts to eliminate him from classroom curricula, and calls for changing the federal holiday have all followed. Whatever your views of the Columbus controversy, this holiday continues to be an important way for all Americans to learn more about the age of exploration and the enormous transformations it brought.
All right, so I think from seeing from your facial expression during some spots in the story, you were shocked to hear about some of the things that Columbus did to the indigenous people. The word dismemberment really shocked you, Christopher, didn't it? Yeah.
I didn't know what it meant, but... sounds bad.
So maybe we need to add that to our vocabulary list.
Yeah.
Right?
That's agree. Good.
Dismembered. Did I spell it right?
I don't know. I don't even know the word.
Okay. So with the story, do you know what it means now?
I use context clues to figure it out.
Okay. So dismemberment is that they pretty much cut up the bodies, right?
Yep.
Pretty gross, pretty terrible things, pretty violent things. So now this is what you're going to do. You're going to listen to the story again. You're going to go to wordart.com And every time you see and hear one of the vocabulary words with an X next to it, you're going to create word art. We've done this before, so you know what to do. You're just, yes, Christopher.
Ma'am, we already marked down when we heard the specific words. Can we just go right into the word art?
No. Yes, go right into the word art. And I'm going to play the story just so those who need to hear it. If you already know the words and create the word art from marking it and circling it, awesome. You could do that. So you're a step ahead of the game, Christopher. So I am going to play it again. And I'm going to go into my word art as it's playing.
As the classroom ride goes, Christopher Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492.
And then we'll compare our word arts together.
But there is more to the story of the explorer we celebrate with a federal holiday on the second Monday of every October. As historians have continued to learn and write more about the real life of Christopher Columbus, controversy has arisen over the validity of honoring the explorer as a hero. Like many European explorers, Columbus encountered many indigenous people throughout his voyages. Singularly focused on his mission to find riches and conquer new lands, Columbus and his teams treated the indigenous groups they came across as obstacles to their greater mission. He labeled Indians. The use of violence and slavery, the forced conversion of native peoples to Christianity, and the introduction of a host of new diseases that would have dramatically subjected them to extreme violence and brutality. On his famous first voyage in 1492, Columbus landed on an island and would be good servant. Within 60 years after Columbus landed, only a few Dominican Republic, according to documents discovered by Spanish historians in 2005 doc. In response to native in addition to the controversy over enslavement and violent rule, the age of exploration Columbus led had the additional consequence of bringing new diseases, animals, and goods between the east and west that his voyages sparked. Though the effects were widespread and cannot...
I think you guys are done with your word art already.
I agree.
All right. All right, Patrick, let me see your word art. I'm trying to get mine up there. Good job. Violence, conquer, Columbus, indigenous, consequences, explorer, you have disease, indigenous. Good job. Christopher, let's see, you have Columbus, conquered indigenous, disease, enslaved, violence.
These look pretty similar to mine.
Consequences, explorer, controversy. Huh. Good job, I'm trying to, let's see if I have all of them. And mine didn't show. All right, so you guys did better than I did. All right, so tomorrow's lesson we're going to define the words. And then we're going to play a math game with the word and the definition. So tomorrow's lesson, we're going to dig deeper into the vocabulary. Good job, everyone.